This video is to discuss Promethean ActivInspire's layers. The layers in ActivInspire allow you to rearrange objects and lock them, hide them, and everything can be manipulated within the object browser. The object browser is the third button at the top in your page browser, so I'm going to click on that to select it. Now you've got four different main layers: the top layer, the middle layer, bottom, and your background layer. Going to go ahead and open this up a little bit so you can see this a little bit better. On your top layer, that's where pen, highlighter, and any magic ink markings are going to go. Your middle layer, all other objects that get created, they automatically go into the middle layer. You can move objects around by dragging and dropping them. So for example, in this page, my ActivInspire text is text 1 and my layers text is text 2. Since the layers text is on top of text 2 is on top of text 1 in the layers panel, it will actually show up on top of it. If I move these two around and say put text 2 on the bottom layer, you can now see that that text is hidden underneath the text 1. So moving layers around, you just drag them and drop them. So now both of my options are in the bottom layer. To rename layers, you simply double click on the layer name in the panel. So now I can actually rename this to layer text, so I know what that is, and I could rename this one to ActivInspire text. In this case, since I only have two layers, it's not really necessary to rename them, but if you had multiple layers, you might find it more easy to rename them so you know what they are without having to click on them to figure that part out. You may notice these little lock symbols. That means these two layers are currently locked. If I go into presentation mode, they can't be moved around. In design mode, I can come back in here and click and move them around. So to lock an object, all you have to do is select it in the layers panel, and you get this little menu option here. You click on that, and as long as locked has a check mark next to it, that means that that layer is locked. If I click on it again, it's going to toggle it off, and now that layer is no longer locked, and the lock icon goes away. You can also right click on a layer and choose locked from that option as well. The next thing you can do with your layers is you can hide them, and this is so that they can't be seen at certain times, and then you can choose to create actions to make them be able to be seen if you would like to. So in this example, I'm going to hide my layer text. I'm going to go to the menu option again, and this time I'm going to choose hidden. So you see you have an eyeball with an X on it, meaning that that layer is hidden. So if I go into presentation mode, it's no longer there. I can't see it. I can't click on it or anything. If I go back to design mode, now that layer can be seen even though it's hidden on my layers panel. And again, I can right click and go to hidden to toggle that setting as well. So let me show you this in action. So here is a flip chart page, roll up my menu, with three pieces of text, text 6, text 3, text 2, and three images. So if I wanted to rename these, I can come in here and double click to rename. So now I know exactly what they are. I can then move these around. So for example, let's say I wanted that alligator to appear as if it was sitting on the chase lounge. The chase lounge is above it, so I can drag it and drop it. Now I can position the alligator so that he is lounging on that chase lounge. Let's say I don't want the graphics to move, I want the students to be able to come up and move the text and put it next to the options that they match. So in this case, I can select all of these together at once by clicking on the first one or the last one, shift, and clicking on the one that I want to go through, and I can lock them all at once, or I can go to each one individually and lock it that way as well. Either way works. So now when I go into presentation mode, these guys down here, these images, they can't be moved, but the text can, so that my student could come up and they could move these to where they go to match. I'm going to go show you one more example. Here's another example. items that are locked. Let's say these blue boxes, I want them to be on top of this text so that I want to reveal the question when I want the students to be able to look at it to answer it. In this case, I'm going to have to figure out shape 10 and shape 9 are those blue boxes. And you can see that when I click on different options in the layers panel, different items get borders around them. So that lets me know which ones they are. So I can, again, use my shift click method, and I can now move these to the top or simply above, keep them in the middle later. And now those questions are hidden until it's time that I want my students to view them. So I'm going to unlock them. And now in presentation mode, I can move this question out of the way, the box out of the way to reveal the question. So now the students could answer that question. And then I can reveal this when I'm ready so that they're not trying to solve two problems at once. So this video was Promethean ActivInspire's Layers.